Mr. Denis Laverne, the soloist here at the Forum in Montreal. As we look at the officials, the referee is Andy Van Helden. On your left is Randy Mitten. On the right, Bob Luther. In goal tonight for the New York Islanders, it'll be Roland Melanson and Rick Wamsley. You see Melanson making only his second lifetime appearance against the Canadiens. Lifetime, 3.00 goals against average. Lost his only outing. That was here. Rick Wamsley, who comes into tonight's game with a record, or goals against, a 3.46. And against the Islanders, making his first appearance ever. Al Arbour sends Brian Trottier to center ice. Mike Bossy on the right wing. John Tinelli on the left with Johnson and Poffin on defense. The puck came back to Johnson, over to Poffin. Acton into forecheck for Montreal. Trottier unable to get out on this right side. Thomas Johnson off the boards to Trottier. Slipped away from Ganey. And Bossy comes over center ice. Bossy, a long shot that was wide. It rebounded in front, but Robinson was there. Robinson and Green together on the Montreal defense. The puck was centered off Green's stick. Nyland tried to clear it, couldn't get it out of there. John Tinelli back. Tinelli skated into the boards by Robinson. Persistent checking of Tinelli's without a stick. Kicked it in front. Trottier shoots and scores. Trottier from Tinelli. Tinelli, soccer fashion, kicked the puck out beautifully right to the stick of Trottier.
He never stops, Jiggs. Let's look here. There he is. Look at 1-2 and then Bing in front. Look at who's standing there. Keith Acton, number 12, allows Trottier the freedom in front of goaltender Wamsley, and Brian Trottier rips it past him right here. Bang. One quick move. Puck kicked out from behind the net. John Tinelli fighting off Robinson and getting the puck to Trottier.
A goal at the 35-second mark. So Brian Trottier has the Islanders on top early in the hockey game. As McEwen goes back forth, plays it over to Morrow on this right side. Let's get the announcement on that goal officially. McEwen gets the assist along with Tinelli. So at 35 seconds, the Islanders on top, and they go offside at the Montreal blue line. You take a look at Brian Trottier.
Heading for the bench, well-deserved rest. The Islanders start quickly again tonight, as they have been doing regularly as of late. Won 6 in a row. Roland Melanson has won 5 in a row. Great way to start on a game, particularly in Montreal. Get a goal early.
Lifetime record in this building for the Islanders, 5-12-3. But have lost only once in their last 5 trips to the Forum. Gillies is out on the left wing with Bourne at center ice and Matt Sahlin on the right side. Canadians have dumped it into the Islanders' zone. They're being booed as they're called for icing. This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the New York Islanders and it's solely for the private, non-commercial use of our audience.
Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the
express written consent of the New York Islanders is prohibited.
Teamwork.
Double-barreled shot there tonight, folks. What a team.
Oh, we have to keep amusing ourselves. Why not? Brian Trottier, his 23rd goal of the season at the 35-second mark.
With a temperature about 5 degrees below 0 Fahrenheit.
I was going to say it's about 5 degrees colder than the time that he scored at with the wind chill factor.
This is Wickenheiser for Montreal with a shot off the blocking glove of Melanson. Langevin up the right side to Alain. It went off his stick and Picard picks it up at center ice. Robert Picard off the boards. There's Langevin back. Wickenheiser into forecheck as Langevin gave the puck to Gillies. Now to Bourne. Bourne on the left side. Sent Alain over the line, but it's offside. A break in the action, 18-12 to play in the first period. The score, Islanders 1, Canadiens nothing.
Trottier, 5 goals, 7 assists, 12 points in his last 8 games. That's after going 3 goals, 4 assists, 7 points in his last 12 games. Or last month, big difference.
Now Tremblay leading the Canadiens in, got the puck to Bonduit. The man out in front couldn't get it to him. Naslin being tied up by Thomas Johnson. The fans yelling for a penalty, none being called. That's Tremblay with Poffin chasing him to the corner. Poffin got it to Gilbert. Out of Goring. Two men back as Goring comes to center ice. Fed it neatly to Thomas Johnson on the right side. Johnson cross ice to Gilbert is reach. So Tremblay sends Bondu back in over the Islander line. His shot went off Poffin and up into the crowd. Well, one of the surprises as far as media here today when we arrived was the fact that the Islanders, although they got a story on the front page, didn't really get as much play as I kind of thought the Stanley Cup champions would. Rather, it went to a junior hockey player by the name of Pat LaFontaine.
Had quite a game, I understand, in Verdun, just outside the city of Montreal last night. A couple of the young stars of hockey playing against each other.
Ludwig on the Montreal defense blasted one from the point that was blocked. Islander fans might want to remember the name I just mentioned. Shot for the drive that was blocked by Melanson. A battle for it in front of the net. It's poked loose and shot goes back. Put it out in front. Nystrom is there to clear it to Gilbert. Greg Gilbert on the left side, forcing the Canadiens to go in deep. Nystrom in quickly, unable to get it to a man, and shot almost handed it to Goring. Goring moved in, knocked down by Delorme, and LaFleur has cleared it to the blue line. Carbonneau, up wing side, it was broken up momentarily. Now Delorme gets over the line, 3-on-1, and his shot was way wide. He had LaFleur headed for the net, the puck went off the glass, and a hard shot up into the crowd.
I would have to think that Bob Barry, coach of the Montreal Canadiens, Jigs, will have to say something. They had LaFleur wide open down the middle on the play. Delorme elected to shoot. He not only shot it poorly, shot it high and wide, but his best option was Guy LaFleur all alone in front of Roland Melanson. There's the check right there. Boom. Butch Goring took a heavy check. He didn't touch the puck. Talk about, you know, maybe an interference call, but the referee's going to let them work it out themselves.
Well, the Islanders, McEwen and Morrow, are teamed up in defense. Trache, Bossy, and Tonelli, the forward line. The Islanders have dumped it down the ice and will be called here for having iced the puck.
First period score, Jig St. Louis leading the New Jersey Devils. 1-0. Andre Dory, the ex-Ranger, has scored for St. Louis.
There's a look at the lone veteran Montreal defenseman at this stage, Larry Robinson.
Victimized right at the beginning of the game. John Tonelli beat him behind the net. Got the puck to Trache, and that's how the Islanders got their first goal.
Acton on that faceoff against Trache, and the puck went back of the net for Morrow. Around to Bossy on the right side. Mike Bossy to McEwen up the left side. That's Tonelli chasing it. Tonelli pull it away from Nyland. Robinson lines him up. The two of them on the boards to get loose for Trache. He was checked from behind by Nyland, and Robinson spins away. Larry Robinson up the right side. The pass just out of the reach of Acton. Melanson out of the net clears it. It goes over the glass and into the crowd. And Acton and Morrow, a little extracurricular activity. Now they all converge. Nyland wants a piece of Morrow. Robinson pushing Morrow back, and the linesman Bob Luther has grabbed hold of Nyland. Nyland is a scrapper. Picks up more penalty minutes in the way of fisticuffs for Montreal than probably any other player on their roster. Andy Van Helleman talking to both Morrow and Nyland, Robinson as well.
He may be telling them that there's no penalties. Keep it up and I'll have to give some.
There's a break in the action. 16-11 to play in the opening period. The score is Islanders 1, Canadiens nothing. Al Arbor has Wayne Merrick at center ice, Brent Sutter on the right wing, and Anders Kaller on the left side for the Islanders. Laffan and Janssen together on defense. Wickenheiser will take the faceoff for Montreal. Napier is on the right side, and on this left wing, Ryan Walter. Johnson with the puck back of his own goal. Thomas Johnson dropped it off for Poffin. Back to Johnson. Comes out to center ice. Neat move to get away from Walter before shooting it around the boards. Walmsley cut it off for Root. Root, the Montreal defenseman, was checked. The puck went loose. Wick will pick it up. Merrick got in front to Brent Sutter, and his shot was blocked. Comes back to Poffin. A drive. Walmsley the save, and Kaller races after the rebound. Kaller tried to set up Johnson. The play was broken up. Canadiens come to center, but Kaller got back. Knocked the puck loose, and here's Poffin as the Canadiens turned away from it. Poffin on the right side for Merrick. Couldn't get there in time. Walter is bumped at the blue line, and here's Johnson. Thomas Johnson across the line, trying to zigzag around Picard, was blocked. And Napier moves down the right wing side. Mark Napier shoots Melanson the save, and the puck is loose in front of the net. Picked off by Kaller. And there's Kaller with Brent Sutter. Kaller, he likes to shoot one in that was gloved, knocked down by Walmsley. Picard goes back of the net, played it up the right side to Napier. Napier's pass in and out of Helene's gates. Napier sends Picard over the line. Picard shot off the toe of Melanson's stick. Killy's out with Bourne and Helene. That's Helene, checked by Picard, and Naslin shoots it in offside at the Islander blue line. We have some news about the NHL All-Star Dinner, which will be held the night before the All-Star game, to pass along a little later. Later on this evening, Ed Westfall will be talking to the recipient of the Lester Patrick Award for 1982.
None other than the Islanders' general manager, Bill Torrey. Quite an honor.
Sure is.
Selected for his contributions in the United States to hockey, the Lester Patrick Award.
Islanders open the scoring at the 35-second mark tonight. Seventh game in a row, 10 out of the 11 that they've scored the opening goal. Naslin kicked the puck off the boards in his own zone. Out to center ice comes DeLorme. His long shot is off the glass. Came to the skates of Bondu, centered it, and right to Langevin. Now to Gillies. Gillies to Mats Helin. Helin across the Montreal line, stops, made the play to Gillies, and was broken up in front of the net. Out to center ice is Bondu. Bondu over the line. Tried to come in on the right side. Morrow got a piece of him. Gillies picks up the puck, had trouble clearing it. Canadians trying to go back of the net and knocked into the boards, and the play was Naslin. It comes to the right side for Helin. DeBourne. Bourne carries it to center. His shot got away from Walmsley, but fortunately for the Canadians, wide of the net. DeLorme played one to center ice out of the reach of Carboneau, and it went right to Melanson. We have just over 13 minutes to play in the opening period. Thomas Johnson to the left wing for Goring is out now with Gilbert and Nystrom, and the Canadians force the Islanders to go back. In quickly is shot. Melanson played it around. Carboneau in after it. Carboneau centers off the stick of LaFleur. A. LaFleur to shot. Back to the right point. Bill Root with a shot. Melanson the save, and Poffin is there. Poffin clears it, held in by Root. Can't get it to Guy LaFleur, but Root broke up the Islander rush, got it to Schutt. Schutt takes a drive, blocked by Johnson, and he covers up. Carboneau and Schutt with a great chance, but the Islanders foil them. A break in the action, 13-11 left in the first period. Our score, the Islanders won, the Canadiens nothing.
First tied at one apiece, Chouinard for the Calgary Flames, Glenn Cochran for the Flyers. That's in the first period.
Here the Islanders are up 1-0. Tonelli out with Trache and Bossy. Tonelli's pass went off Trache's skates. Rick Green, the former Washington defenseman, has shot it into the corner. Melanson out of the net to clear, and it goes over the glass and into the crowd. Well, the news surrounding the All-Star Dinner at the Nassau Coliseum on Monday, February 7th, the master of ceremonies will be none other than the Right Reverend Saul Hargis.
Hey, all right, Don Imus.
That's
what
it.
What a great selection. Look forward to that. A very talented man.
Hope he brings Earl C. Watkins with him. Looking forward to it. Ann Murray will be on hand. More details a little later on. Green with a shot. Melanson out of the net to clear the puck to Pearson. Stefan Pearson bumped by Ganey, but managed to get it to Langevin, to Bossy. The pass to Trache, back to Langevin. Ganey into forecheck for Montreal. Langevin to Pearson. Stefan Pearson. Trache with the pass. It goes right to the Montreal goalmouth and is cleared by Walmsley. Bossy chases it to the corner, got his stick back from Green, but couldn't regain control of the puck. Green kicked it ahead to Nylon on right wing. Out to center ice for Acton, a shot from the blue line. Blocked by Melanson, dropped it off to Trache. Ryan Trache takes a look. Up the middle it goes to Bossy, cuts to the left side, gave it to Tonelli. Tonelli trying to get in around Robinson, couldn't do it, and out come the Canadians. The pass to LaFleur failed to materialize. Langevin to Tonelli, now to Trache. Back to John Tonelli. Lost it at center ice. Canadiens clear it to the Islander line. That's Pearson. Stefan Pearson played it between Robinson's skates, and LaFleur gives chase. Canadiens are out shooting the Islanders 4-3, but the Islanders lead 1-0. Gilly slams into Robinson with a hard check. McEwen was knocked down as he played it to the right side for Morrow. Morrow to Helin, backhanded it across the line. Gilly steps into Green, that's him down. That's Helin to Gillies, unable to set up Bourne, and here's Carbon. Guy Carboneau shoots it into the Islander zone. Melanson fed it off for Morrow. Morrow checked back of the goal. Carboneau centers one. LaFleur took it in the skates and had to go to the corner to recover. LaFleur to shot. The Carboneau centers loose in front. LaFleur feeds it to Ludwig at the blue line. His drive is off the target. Comes out in front. LaFleur had been knocked down. Fans are really upset. No penalty call. Now Carboneau unable to center the puck. Here is Bob Bourne. Bourne dumps it into center. some strange things going on in the public address system while play is going on. It sounds like Pac-Man. In the meantime, the Islanders control the puck again. Borough at center, fires it high, deep into the Montreal zone, off the boards for Delorme. Delorme up the right wing, a neat pass to Napier. Art Napier put on the brakes, tries to make the play, got it to Walter. He shoots Melanson, got his right shoulder on it. And Poffin feeds it up quickly for Brent Sutter. Sutter shot it in wide of the goal, in quickly as Keller, a drive off the stick of the goaltender Wamsley. Now Brent Sutter sets up Keller. Keller in the faceoff circle, shooting, and that was off the target. Napier for Canadiens. Ahead to Delorme. Delorme, a long shot right into the catching glove of Melanson, dropped it. Well, he did not. He held it for a faceoff instead. So we'll get a draw on the Islander end of the ice. A break in the action. Little more than 10 minutes to play in the first period. The score is Islanders 1, Canadiens nothing.
Kind of tempo in a hockey game we expected. Good end-to-end action, good puck handling. LaFleur a couple of times. Carboneau gave him the puck, but it was in his skates.
Islanders gave it away, and Napier has drilled it wide. Stefan Persson to the right side for Brent Sutter. Bumped by Wickenheiser. Sutter ran into Picard. The puck came to Napier. Napier to the right side. Bill Root with a shot. Pad saved by Melanson, and he holds on.
Roland Melanson looking sharp again in the Islander net. Good pressure by the Montreal Canadiens. Root, number 18, let go of 8 point. A hard shot. Melanson partially screened on the play. Got a piece of it. Let's take a look. There's the shot, a good one. Look at the reaction of goaltender Roland Melanson as he scoops up the puck after making the save. Root was drafted from the Niagara Falls Flyers, 23 years old, played last year, part of this year, at Nova Scotia.
Some unusual names on the Montreal defense. Delorme, Root, Ludwig, Green. Natras not dressed tonight, but certainly not the Robinsons and the others that we've come to know, like Savards. And more recently, of course, the play of Engblom and Langway, who have since been traded to the Washington Capitals, but it's not the Montreal team of old, defensively anyway.
Time takes its toll.
Indeed. Nystrom playing the puck around the boards. Trombley in after it. Gilbert checked him, overcomes Root. Root played it to the corner, but right to Greg Gilbert. To Mike McEwen, up the left boards, held in by Root. To Trombley, who missed it. Now Mondeau, unable to center, as checks him. Kenny Morrow has it in his skate, scoring in to help out. The puck came back of the net and on the mesh, and play is called.
Look at Ken Morrow. Fans thought he should have been in the penalty box a moment ago. He upended Guy Lafleur as the Flower headed for the front of the net. Looked me for an opening play. Morrow took him down. Referee is not going to jump on everything he sees. So far, he's going to let the players decide the level and the tempo of the game.
Now this is Gilbert shooting it into the Montreal zone. Ludwig cleared it out of there to Morrow of the Islanders, to Goring. Butch Goring, stick handling to the Montreal line, lost it. Trombley had knocked it off his stick. Mondeau gave it back to Trombley into the right side. This is Mondeau. Fanned on the shot as McEwen caught up with him. Cleared right back to the blue line. Delorme with the drive, blocked in front of the net. Nystrom unable to pick it up. Here's Mondeau. Pierre Mondeau centering attempt over top of McEwen's stick. Trombley in the corner, bumped by Gilbert. They shove at one another. Over comes McEwen, a piece of Naslund. Gilbert down, poked the puck loose, but right to Trombley. Mario Trombley into the corner. McEwen got a stick on it. Now Trombley for Montreal. The Mondeau, checked by Morrow. They tied up on the boards. Trombley comes in late with a hit, ran into Mondeau, actually. Mondeau centers, nobody there for either team, and it slides harmlessly down into the Montreal zone. Canadiens with 8 shots on goal, the Islanders with 3. We have 8 minutes and 20 seconds left in the opening period. 1-0 Islanders on Brian Trottier's 23rd goal year. Poffin back, gave the puck to Trottier, out to Bossy, out to Johnson on the right side. Johnson dropped it to the open wing, there was nobody there. Bob Gainey forces Poffin to go back. So the Islander captain checks out the options, played it up the middle and right to Gainey. Gainey comes over the line, stayed onside. Gainey recovers the puck, then Trottier knocks it loose. Delorme didn't wait long enough for his teammates to get back onside. Trottier, rink wide to Bossy. Bossy back to Johnson, to Mike Bossy. Johnson. Johnson comes over center ice, over the Montreal line with a slap shot that was wide of the net. Backcourt is Delorme. Delorme to Nyland, checked by Bossy. Bossy shot it wide. Rick Green, number five for the Canadiens, plays it up the right wing, held in by Bossy. Bossy's shot is blocked. Comes out to center ice for Poffin. Poffin lost it to Nylund. Nylund on a break. Melanson came out to meet him. Got slammed head first by Nylund, and the puck goes to the corner. Melanson has been shaken up. Melanson gambling. Helmet appeared to make contact with Nylund's knee. We'll get another look at it, but trainer Ron Waske out now to attend to Roland Melanson.
A heavy collision, Jiggs. Both players committed. Nylund for Montreal. And, of course, Roland Melanson right here. The puck taken away from Dennis Potvin. And on comes Chris Nylund. You see Roland Melanson charge out of the net to knock the puck away as Nylund dove for the puck. So did Melanson. The ensuing collision, like two freight cars, has kept Roland Melanson on the ice. Taking the action here in the Montreal Forum. The score, the Islanders won. The Canadiens, nothing.
On the reaction of Coach Al Arbour.
You see the goal stick being handed to Billy Smith. Appears that Billy Smith is going to come out onto the ice anyway. I got to bet that Roland Melanson will remain in the net. But we'll wait and see. I've been wrong before.
Well, Smitty had the helmet on. They'd gone for his stick, as you pointed out. The trainer, Ron Waske, has Melanson up on his skates and back into the goal mouth at this moment. Ryan Trotche has been the man relaying the information to Al Arbour. And you see Ron Waske heading back to the players' bench, and Melanson is going to stay in there.
He come to play, Jakes. Players want to play in a hockey game like this. High-intensity game of an important hockey game. Kind of game they like to play. It's going to be hard-hitting. It's going to be fast. It's going to have all the fundamentals, all the things the players like. I don't think you'll see the high sticks. No one's going to take a lot of chippy penalties in a game like this. They have respect for each other and their ability to score on the power play.
So Melanson stays in, the face-off to his left. A daring play to knock the puck away from Nylund. It's 1-0 Islanders. False start from the face-off. And they'll do it again to the left of the Islander net.
False face-off. Not often it happens, but occasionally.
Trotche with Acton on the face-off. The Islanders got the draw. Trotche pulled it back to Poffin, and now Bossy sends Trotche to center. Back it into the Montreal zone. That's Robinson going back in the net. Robinson almost handed it to Bossy, but it went off the boards instead, and this is Johnson. Thomas Johnson to Bossy. Bossy to the right side. Tinelli to Johnson. Johnson dumps it in wide of the Montreal goal. Bossy and Nylund bumped together. Trotche picked up the puck, gave it to Tinelli, and a shot hit the post. Off the post to the left of Wansley. Johnson from the point. The shot hit Tinelli. Trotche can't knock it away from Robinson. Bossy picks it up. Bossy checked on the boards. Trotche in to pick up the puck. Gave it to Tinelli. Tinelli out to Bossy. Robinson cleared that aside. Trotche to Tinelli. Knocked down behind the net. No penalty. Bossy with the puck. Put it out in front. They bang at it. It's at the side of the net. Ganey unable to clear it. Picked up by Acton. The play has been called as Green will go out for holding. He was all over top of Bossy. And the Islanders get the first power play of the hockey game.
A holding penalty. It appears to go to Rick Green, number five. One-time Washington Capital. Washington's first pick, first overall in 1976. Came here in that multiplayer trade back in September. John Tinelli trying to get loose in front of the net. He and Bossy were both buzzing around. Trotche trying to get the puck to him. Green grabbed a hold, as we see in front of the net. Rick Green holding John Tinelli.
So the Islanders with Bourne at center ice. Alain on the right side, Gillies on the left. We look at it again in front of that Montreal goal. Number five, Rick Green. It was Tinelli that he dragged down. The Montreal penalty killing ranks 19th in a 21-team league. So the Islanders with a chance to extend their lead. McEwen from the right point faked it, gave it to Gillies. Back to McEwen. And off his stick, a loose puck, and McEwen able to cover up in time. Gave it to Pearson, to Bourne. Bob Bourne back to McEwen. Rank wide off the boards. Pearson failed to pick it up. Helene comes to the Montreal line. Ran into Root as he dumped it around the boards. Canadians trying to clear it out. Pearson held it in. Got it to Helene. Knocked away from him. And Mondeau has cleared it down into the Islander zone. Walter into forecheck as McEwen picks up the puck. Bourne heads to the far side of the ice. McEwen comes up the middle with it. at center ice, had a rolling puck to contend with, and his shot was blocked. Cleared by Schley right to McEwen. McEwen played it in front of the net. Canadiens had trouble with it. Root got it to Picard, then off Bourne's stick and into the crowd. And ruling that went off a Canadian stick, so they'll face off right on the edge of the circle to the right of the net. 1:05 left in the Islander power play, by the way.
Picard, Robert Picard, one-time Washington Capital, also went to Toronto and then from there here to Montreal. There he is, Jacques Laperriere, an all-star defenseman for many years with Montreal. You talked about the Montreal defense, and you always looked at the Montreal team and having one of the best defense ever. One of the reasons, right there, Jacques Laperriere, now assistant coach to Bob Barry, works with the defense, the young defense of the Montreal Canadiens, trying to shore up what they call are a little bit weak in defense here. So Jacques Laperriere is going to apply his expertise with the young players.
Large part of his asset would be that reach.
Long reach and a tremendous shot. A great playmaking ability, but harder to get around than a freight train.
Piece of experience. Robinson bumped on the boards by Bossy, but Robinson able to recover the puck. The Islanders will have to go back. 40 seconds left in this power play chance. That is Poffin with the puck. Comes over the center ice stripe to the Montreal line, cuts to the left side. Tinelli went to the net, the puck went to Pearson. Pearson shot, right on, Walmsley the save. Poffin in after it. Back of the net to Trottier. Trottier to Poffin. Back to Pearson. Stefan Pearson gave it to Bossy. Bossy at the edge of the circle, rink wide to Poffin. Poffin to Bossy, he shoots, Walmsley the save, they score and the rebound. Tinelli with Trottier there, may have been Trottier who tipped it. Tinelli took the shot. Trottier, I think, got a piece of it. It's 2-0 Islanders. A power play goal at 15:31.
Dennis Poffin to Bossy. Look at the hard shot stopped by Walmsley. There's the rebound. John Tinelli and Brian Trottier both poke at it, but it's John Tinelli. There's a bird's eye view power play of the New York Islanders. There's the pass. Poffin to Bossy. His quick shot. And John Tinelli puts the rebound in. Number 27 for Montreal, Gilbert Delorme. Not on and close enough to keep Tinelli from pushing the puck in.
So up 2-0 the first period. The Canadians with a chance of Picard fanned on the shot as Lafleur set him up neatly. This is Goring at the Montreal line. Picard came over to take it away from him. Picard to the right side. This is Guy Lafleur. Ryan Trottier gets credit for the goal. Apparently he touched it before it crossed the goal line. Puck in the Islanders' zone, not tied up. Lafleur and Nystrom bump together, and here's McEwen. So Tinelli and Bossy will get assists. Trottier went over to talk to Tinelli immediately, like apologizing for having touched it. That was the tip-off. Canadians fired deep in the Islanders' zone, off the boards. Lafleur knocked it down. A hand pass is called. His shot picked it up. Fans disagree with Andy Van Helleman, but a good call.
Guy Lafleur had batted the puck clearly, and the next player to touch it was one of his teammates. Stoppage of play. I'm going to say, if Tinelli got the goal, you know that Tinelli has scored 8 goals in his last 5 games. That's after scoring only 7 in his previous 36. So he's catching fire. One of the reasons the Islanders are doing much better, John Tinelli. Flyers have scored again. Clark has scored. They lead Calgary 2-1. That's in the Syriot. And the Devils and St. Louis are now tied. Brent Ashton has scored for the Devils. Tied at 1 apiece.
New Jersey trying to get out of last place in the Patrick Division. Playing at home tonight as we watch Caller come to center ice. Shot it wide of the net. Brent Sutter in after it. Couldn't get there in time. Caller had trouble with it. The puck went loose and Trombley fed it up quickly to Naslin. Naslin unable to handle it at center ice. And this is Pearson to Langevin. Off the left wing to Caller. The Montreal zone, they got it to Mondoon, and Naslin on the left side. Naslin shot wide on the glove side. Trombley plays it back of the net. Naslin unable to control it, however, and it comes up the right wing, picked up by Wayne Merrick. Merrick to Caller over the Montreal line. Caller fires one wide. Merrick with the rebound, put it off to the side of the net, and Walmsley covers up and holds on. Well, our next action for you on WOR-TV a week from tonight. The New York Islanders and the Los Angeles Kings from the Forum in L.A. That game will be at 30 Eastern time. And then on Saturday night, the 29th, the Islanders and the Vancouver Canucks from Pacific Coliseum in Vancouver. So those will be the next two, in fact, the last two games during the month of January. Islanders hockey on WOR-TV.
NHL scoreboard, Jig, second period action. The Bruins lead Buffalo 1-0. Keith Fergus has scored again for the Boston Bruins. He got the winning goal the other night against Minnesota. He scored at 9:46 of the third period to give the Bruins a 4-3 win over Minnesota.
You see where Wayne Gretzky finally scored on a penalty shot?
On a penalty shot. There is such a thing. I wonder how it happened. Somebody fell on the puck, put his hand on the puck in the crease, maybe.
I think he was pulled down from behind.
Oh,
from what
no,
I read.
They don't get penalty shots for
oh,
that, Jake.
Oh, sure.
They do?
Yeah, we're going to get the tape and have a drill session right with you on how those are called.
Okay.
Root to Walter, and he shot it wide of the Islander net. Poffin off the boards, out to Gillies. It was knocked away from him, picked up by Poffin. Poffin sends him into the Montreal zone. Matt Sahlin, number 20, is third game, making his fourth in the NHL after having played one earlier in Detroit. Two in a row at home prior to coming here tonight. Napier's pass cut off by Johnson at the Islander line. We've got a penalty call coming up against the New York Islanders. So the Canadiens will get their first power play chance. The Islanders have killed off 18 consecutive penalties, and we see the reason for this call.
A hooking penalty. Bob Bourne, see him get a hold of the Montreal player from behind with a stick, pull him down, and there is the penalty box. Bob Bourne is in it here in the Montreal Forum. Seems like such a long time since I've said here in the Montreal Forum.
It has been a while. Last time here, the Islanders defeated the Canadiens 2-1 in a classic Halloween night, 1981. So Bourne is off for hooking at 17:59. While the Montreal penalty killing is struggling, so is the power play. It, too, is 19th in the league, connecting at only 18.6% of their chances. When was the last time that happened? Goring across the line. Back to Langevin. Over to Persson. The other Islander player on the ice is Tinelli, and this is Goring. Chased off the puck by Robinson. Back for it is Green. Green, Robinson, shot. Lafleur and Carbonneau, the Montreal power play. They have trouble coming out of their own zone at the moment. Robinson around to Green. Gave it to Robinson. Gets out over the line. A pass on the right wing to Schutt. Shot it into the Islander end of the ice. Melanson back of the net cuts it off. Laid one off the glass that hit Carbonneau. Goes loose back of the goal, and Persson clears it. Lafleur gives chase. Guy Lafleur to Green. Green at the Islander line. Over to Robinson. To Schutt. Shot, fake the shot, back to Robinson with it. Robinson starts in on the right wing, gave it to the corner, comes right back to Schutt. The drive off Goring's stick, Lafleur, a shot, he scores!
Who said Guy Lafleur is not dangerous? He has only 13 goals, but he has just scored a big one for his team, the Montreal Canadiens. There's Steve Schutt, his shot partially blocked to Lafleur. Look how quick he puts that in, just in on the short side, on the left side. Quickly, there's the shot by Schutt, deflected off Goring, right to Guy Lafleur, and bang, it's in that quick. And the Montreal Canadiens are on the scoreboard with a power play goal. Guy Lafleur getting his 14th of the season. It's 2-1 now for the New York Islanders.
Went for the short side. The goal at 18:58. So a power play goal for Montreal. Less than a minute to play in the opening period. The Islanders have cleared the puck into center ice. Gillies backhands it in right to Walmsley. But the whistle had sounded.
Offside, Jiggs, a two-line offside. The puck was high in the air and bouncing. Bart Gillies had crossed the center ice line.
Assisted by
the puck came over behind. We take a close look at Green. Rick Green, number five. And there, Mike McEwen. There's Bart Gillies.
The Montreal goal is Lafleur from Schutt and Carbonneau at 18:58. Here's Green from the point. His shot was blocked. Goes to the side of the Islander net. Melanson gave it to McEwen around to Bossy. Back to Michael McEwen. To Bossy, poked it to Morrow. Morrow up the right side. Bossy with it now. Bossy to Trotsky. Acton checked him. Forces the Islanders to go back. Morrow tries the other side. Clark Gillies picked it up, then lost it. Robinson shot, steered aside by Melanson. The Canadiens all over the Islanders at the moment. Nylund got it to Green, back to Nylund. 15 seconds remaining in the period. Nylund around the boards, and there's McEwen. Michael McEwen feeds Bossy on right wing. Long pass tipped by Robinson. Trache picks it up. Shot it into the Montreal zone, and that does it for the opening period as Green touches up. The sounds bringing to a close the first period of action here in Montreal. The Islanders were outshot 10-7 in the period, but they lead after one. Our score from Montreal, the New York Islanders 2, the Montreal Canadiens 1. We'll have a recap for you, but first, these messages.
Use the defender as a screen and maybe even deflected it off him. And it's Sittler's 433rd goal, number 1,000 as far as points are concerned, in a very, very outstanding career.
I believe Barber and Marsh will pick up the assists on that goal. Sittler's 30th of this year, and as Eddie said, the 433rd of his career, 1,000 points. And the fans here are getting a commemorative pamphlet, much the same that they got, or they received rather, when Bobby Clark scored his 1,000th point. And Clark and Sittler both in that elite group. Sittler has to be pretty happy with the fact that he scored it not only at home, but that he's finally scored it. As you take a look at 1,000 point club, Sittler just 21 points behind the Ranger great Rod Gilbert, but nonetheless he gets it on a goal, and a goal that he blew by Donnie Edwards.
There's a drive by Hislop turned away.
Well, he made sure that he went and got that puck, as you see it there, and he gave it to the trainer. I should say the equipment man, young Jim Evers, commonly known as the Turk.
You see that puck on a plaque on Sittler's wall in his rec room very, very soon.
Ken was the time of that goal here in the second period. And again, it was his 30th goal of the year. Billy Barber and Brad Marsh get the assists. So Brad Marsh will go in the record book.
Riseborough and Clark on this test, and it's McCrimmon with a drive, and that one.
Consecutive penalties to LaFleur's goal at 18:58. We're outshot in the period by a margin of 10-7.
Somebody's birthday today. Did you know whose?
Well, Billy Carroll's yesterday.
No, today.
It's today.
Meg Gruber. It's her birthday.
Who?
Meg Gruber. Got a nice letter from Claudia Fetters saying that she and her friend watch all of the Islander broadcasts, go to some of the games in Washington and Pittsburgh, and they're great Islander fans, particularly of Brian Trache and Dave Langevin. And got this nice letter from Claudia Fetters saying it was Meg Gruber's birthday. Wanted to wish her a happy birthday, so we'll extend that.
I'll join in with a chorus myself.
Please don't. On a spoiler birthday. You're going to sing, are you?
No.
Okay.
Pass. From the faceoff, the puck had gone over the board, struck one of the ushers right on the derriere, as they call it here. So now Trache on the faceoff against Gainey. The puck went to Tinelli on left wing, back to Poffin. Shot it into the Montreal zone. Bossy and after it. It was poked away from him by Green, and Gainey forces Trache to go back into the Islander zone. Trache handed it to Acton. His drive. Melanson the save. Gainey is shot. Blasted it wide of an open goal. Bob Gainey, usually very consistent in a situation like that, drilled it wide, and the Islanders get another big break. This is Trache on the right side. Gave the pass to Bossy. Now to John Tinelli. Tinelli poked it in around Green. Robinson chasing it. Harry Robinson, Tinelli on top of him. Here's Bossy to Tinelli. Tinelli trying to go back of the net. One hands it in front of the stick of Bourne, and it's cleared up the right side for Nyland. Nyland and Gainey come to center ice. Nyland shot it high over the net. Nyland in to pick it up. Janssen bumps into him. Nyland still tries to center. Poffin, without the helmet, gave the puck to Janssen. Thomas Janssen into center ice. As Gillies on the left side, Park just inside the line, played it to Gillies, who had cut to the right. Gillies centering attempt, cleared by Robinson, up to Nyland. Nyland to the left side, and Picard, the defenseman, fires one off the stick of Thomas Melanson. This is Kenny Morrow at center ice, checked on the boards by Wickenheiser. Gillies shot, blocked by Napier. Ryan Walter in the center ice zone was checked. So back for Montreal is Bill Root. Canadiens trailing 2-1. Wickenheiser failed to pick up the puck at center ice. It's cleared in across the line by Helene to Bourne. Bourne is checked on the boards. Bill Root failed to clear it out. McEwen dumps it to the far corner, and Wickenheiser for the Canadiens starts to lead the rush into center ice. Gave the puck to Walter, who angled up. Walter back to Picard, over to Root. Rode at center ice, fires a long shot wide of the net, but offside is called. We have 18:06 to play in period two. The score, with a break in the action, the Islanders 2 and the Canadiens 1.
Face off in the center ice zone. Jiggs McDonald with Ed Westfall here at the Forum in Montreal. Carboneau got the face off away from Butch Goring, and now Carboneau fires one high up into the seats behind the Islander net. You mentioned birthdays. He's only one of many with January birthdays.
Yes, well, we have some. Of course, you mentioned Billy Carroll. Yeah. Mike Bossy on Saturday will be 26. Greg Gilbert on Saturday also will be 21. And he says me here. Now, you know who me is?
Yeah.
Eric Hornick is up here from school at the game doing some of our stats, as he did for years at the Coliseum. We welcome him.
He'll be 19. He was 19 yesterday. And his mother had a birthday on Tuesday.
Oh, wonderful. Well, we got all that in for Eric.
No, we missed one. Wayne Gretzky will be 22 next Wednesday.
He's over the hill.
Goring and LaFleur battling for the puck, and the Canadiens won control of it. This is Delorme out to center, but missed Carboneau with the pass. Nystrom, checked by Schutt. Morrow takes control in the Islanders' zone, giving it to McEwen. Michael McEwen. Greg Gilbert tipped it into the center ice zone. Now Schutt picks it up on left wing. Carboneau trailing. LaFleur heads for the net. The pass was deflected by Morrow, and Nystrom comes out over the line. DeGoring at the Montreal line, unable to get through the defense. A backhand shot went wide. Gilbert picks it up. Greg Gilbert takes a look. The pass to Goring in deep. Goring shoots, hit the side of the net, and it comes right back to Walmsley. Goring pulled in, went to the backhand, but couldn't put it in.
Close call, the Islanders. Good passing. Greg Gilbert to Butch Goring right there. Fine play. Goring goes wide on Walmsley. Miscues on the backhand. Puck seemed to stick to his stick just a little too long as he took it to the backhand, tried to put it in the short side, hit the outside of the net. There's Rick Walmsley from Simcoe, Ontario. Montreal's fifth pick back in 1979.
Simcoe, the home of Red Kelly. Former Detroit, Toronto great. Mondu at center ice over the Islander line, cutting to the right wing. His shot steered aside by Melanson. Mondu tried to put it out in front. It hit Merrick. On bump this time by Langevin, who got it to Kaller. And Kaller has cleared it down the boards into the Montreal zone. Picard goes back around to the left side for Naslund. Naslund failed to pick it up. Pearson at center ice to Brent Sutter. Sutter over the Montreal line. Faked the shot. Gave the puck to Merrick. Into the corner for Brent Sutter. Root riding hurt on him. Now Kaller pokes at it. It came loose, but to the right side. Tremblay without a stick. Let it go to Bill Root. Root over center ice, shot it into the Islanders' zone off Langevin's stick, Melanson for side. So Wayne Merrick fires it around to the right wing for Brent Sutter. Sutter out with Kaller and Merrick have trouble getting out of their own zone. Mondu centered one in front, nobody there, and it's picked up by Kaller. Kaller checked by Tremblay, and the Islanders are forced back. Dave Langevin up the right wing to Pearson, to Merrick, tips it into the center ice zone. Robinson hustles back. They played just over 4 minutes of the second period, 2-1 Islanders. Keith Acton to Ganey on left wing. His shot blocked by Melanson, and he'll hold it for a fake. We get a break in the action. 15 minutes and 40 seconds to play in the second period. The score is Islanders 2, Canadiens 1. Assist on both goals now. They've taken the one away from McEwen on the first goal of the game and given it to Bossy. So Strache from Tonelli and Bossy at 35 seconds. Same story at 15:31. Canadiens trying to tie it up with a shot that was steered aside by Melanson, and this is Mike Bossy. Bossy from center ice, shot it wide of Walmsley. Trotsky in quickly, and he blasted it high and wide, and it rebounds all the way down into the Islander zone. Melanson leaves it for Poffin, the first man back. He and Janssen together on defense, and the shot went right off Janssen, and fortunately wide of the net. Now Poffin just reached out and took it away from Nyland. The Trotsky up the right side to Bossy. Bossy checked by Green. Thomas Janssen and Green in a battle for it along the boards. Green poked it across the line, but Trache was there. This is Poffin now. Poffin to Gillies. Clark Gillies slipped away from Nyland, but lost it to Robinson. Robinson bumped by Gillies, and Trache shot it into the Montreal zone. Islanders and Canadiens changing on the fly. Canadiens come to center. Ryan Walter checked on the boards by Bourne. Overcame Helene as well. He has Wickenheiser tied up. We'll get a face-off in the center ice zone. Well, John Tinelli with a pair of goals on Tuesday night in that 8-1 victory over Hartford has passed Ed Westfall for eighth place on the all-time New York Islander goal list.
Boy, it took him a long time. He must have his feet buried in sand, that guy. He just passed me.
I didn't want to use that. It's a negative.
Flyers now leading Calgary 5-1.
Wow.
Barber has got a goal and Sittler has two. Or Barber has two, I'm sorry, and Sittler one.
Flyers started the game 5 points ahead of the Islanders. The two teams meet Saturday night at the Nassau Coliseum. Here's Bob Bourne sending Gillies over the line, but McEwen had been knocked down, pushed across the line by Picard before the puck arrived, so the Islanders are called offside.
St. Louis and the New Jersey Devils are locked at 3 apiece. Second period score. Mullen has scored, and Brian Sutter for St. Louis. Ashton, Lever, Antonovich.
Here, Trotche has scored twice. Lafleur has the Montreal goal. Bourne at center ice, Helene on the right side, Gillies on the left. Bourne got the draw, but it went right back into his own zone. So Morrow feeds it to McEwen. Up the middle to Bourne, left to Gillies, across the line. Gillies tried to cut to the right, couldn't get inside. The puck came loose, picked up by Helene. Back to McEwen. McEwen a shot, blocked by Walmsley. The rebound, Bourne shoots in some skates and a pileup in front of the net and covered by Picard. Walter has tied up Bourne, some general shoving, but nothing develops as of this moment.
Good opportunity for Bob Bourne. Stopped Picard in front of the net, wrestling with Clark Gillies. There's the shot by McEwen. Walmsley's down, there's the backhand shot. Walmsley actually got a piece of it. You see Gillies tied up with Picard. Picard's down on the ice at the top of the crease, able to deflect the puck, get it back to the goaltender so he could hang on to it. Close call as the Islanders press, trying to increase their lead. They're leading 2-1 at this point. 13:45 remaining here in the second period. 2-1 Islanders.
Arbeneau knocked the draw away from Goring, and the Canadiens have slapped it down inside the Islanders' zone. Langevin chased by Lafleur as he picked it up. Failed to clear it out. It Carbonell went for it. To Carbonell, he shoots and it's blocked.
Dave Langevin, good defensive move as he slides down, breaking up Carbonell's shot. He and Lafleur teaming up. Carbonell electing to shoot the puck. Puck, the shot hurt Dave Langevin. You can see him winch a little bit getting up, kind of banged his stick against his knee pads. Sacrifices it takes to be a winning team. He does it regularly. Dave Langevin.
Goring got it away from Carbonell to Pearson to Gilbert. Greg Gilbert rink wide to Nystrom. Nystrom shot it into the Montreal zone. Collided with Ludwig, and then Goring steps into his man, trying to put it out in front of the net. Tangled up in DeLorme's skates, comes out in front. Nystrom turns, shoots, and it hit the defenseman Ludwig. Now Nystrom out to Goring, and Carbonell knocked it away from him. Steve Schott feeds it into center ice. Lafleur picks it up on right wing. Lafleur to Carbonell. Carbonell can't center. Picks it up again. It's checked from behind by Pearson. And Greg Gilbert feeds it quickly to Nystrom on right wing. Comes over the line. Grabbed, turned around by Lafleur. Nystrom recovered the puck. Played it back of the net, but Carbonell stepped in front of Gilbert. Carbonell to Schott. Right back to Carbonell. Lafleur moves up right wing as Carbonell feeds the pass to him. Lafleur takes it off the boards. Can't center as Langevin caught up with him. Langevin around to Nystrom. Now to Merrick. Wayne Merrick is at center ice. Backhands the puck into the Montreal zone. The Islanders complete the player change. Brent Sutter out with Caller and Merrick. On defense, Poffin and Yon. The Canadiens have shot it into the Islanders zone. A race for it. Poffin gets there ahead of Tremblay, and that'll be icing against Montreal.
Guy Lafleur, not the imposing figure we've seen, Jiggs, over the years, does not seem to have the same bounce, the same threat in his skate and puck handling. A break in the action here at the Montreal Forum with the Islanders leading Montreal 2-1. We'll be right back.
Wayne Merrick on this faceoff in the Montreal zone. Got the puck to Brent Sutter. Turn, shoots, and it just went wide. Merrick comes back of the net. Wayne Merrick and Mondeau fighting control of it. Mondeau down has tied up Merrick's stick. Wayne Merrick managed to kick it loose. And Tremblay tried to go right over top of Merrick. Looked like a goal line effort for a touchdown, didn't it?
Merrick looks at him and says, now what are you trying to do that for? Too many players laying around. They want to freeze the puck. Can't play hockey laying on the ice. Tremblay.
All of the Islanders. Islanders extend their very best wishes to the Nets in their efforts to represent the American League, or American Conference, I should say, as they go to Miami for the weekend. A lot of Jets, Islander fans, we are looking for a win in the Orange Bowl, fellas. Trombley at center ice, shot it wide of the Islander goal. Back for it is Brent Sutter. Sutter put it right out in front of the net. Islanders couldn't clear it. Mondu, centering attempt, went off the skate of Naslin. Naslin into the corner to Trombley. Back to Naslin. Naslin can't center it. It's finally underneath the covers. Janssen is down, and we'll get a face-off to the right of Roland Melanson.
The Buffalo-Boston game is now 2-0. That's the second period score. Fergus, we had told you, scored for Boston. Now Bruce Crowder. He is on a roll now. 2 the other night. Another goal tonight as the Bruins lead Buffalo 2-0.
Boston has had the Canadiens number in this building. They've won here 6-4 and 2-1 this season. Chicago, the only other winner, defeated the Canadiens by an 8-7 score.
Prior to that, they hadn't won here in Montreal since like 1976.
Yeah, it had been a long time. Now Trottier on this faceoff against Acton. Canadiens got the draw. Green shot hit Trottier. Comes to the right side, and Trottier is able to clear it down into the Montreal zone. Robinson back on defense, gave it to Gainey. Gainey, the Montreal captain, played it off Nyland skates, and McEwen forces the Canadiens to chase it. Rick Green, Trottier out of line. Tonelli off the play instead, and the puck comes out to center ice. Chris Nyland, a long shot, wide of Melanson. Gainey after it. Morrow knocked it away from it. It goes over the glass and into the crowd.
Game getting much closer in the checking department.
And closer in that area as they start to throw the fists at one another.
McEwen and Gainey having a couple of words.
Seemed very innocent, just conversation. Then all of a sudden, they backed up their words. And you see the result. Gainey and Trottier waltzing. Referee Andy Van Helleman with a few words of warning. And it lingers on. These guys have been teammates in some cases. You look at Gainey and Trottier and Bossy, who have all been on Canada Cup representatives. Robinson as well, but now Ref Andy Van Helleman will hand out some penalties. We get a break in the action with 11:06 to play in the second period. The score is the Islanders 2 and the Canadiens 1. Michael McEwen for the Islanders. Bob Gainey for the Canadiens. Each off for roughing at 8:54. Game's at 5 aside as Green tries to get over the Islander line on this right wing. Was bumped by Langevin. Trottier picks up the puck. Around to Persson. Persson hit hard by Walter. The puck comes out over the line. Trottier controls it at center ice. Green back for the Canadiens. Can't walk in around him. And Robinson got back in time to help out. Check by Bossy. Robinson picks it up again. Islanders with two men in forechecking at the moment. Robinson had it stolen by Trottier to Bossy, coming in on goal, and he was checked by Green. Trottier will pick it up. Trottier to Bossy. Bossy knocked off the puck by Green, and here comes Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser stick handles over the Islander line to the right side for Walter. Ryan Walter chased to the corner by Langevin. Walter comes off the boards, trying to get it to Robinson, is checked from behind. Trottier pins it on the boards, and there's no further play.
Robinson and Green in trouble. They have been in the first period. Again here in the second. The Islanders put a little pressure on Robinson. I'm a little surprised, Jiggs. He waits so long to make the play. Lets the oncoming forward, a forechecker, get too close to him before he makes his play, and he's putting it into the skates. Could have been very costly there as Mike Bossy broke away. Green, with a good second effort, was able to Bossy just before he released his shot.
And that is so unlike Robinson, who moved the puck so quickly in the past.
An all-star defenseman in the past. Unusual to see him hanging on to the puck. Generally, that's a sign of being unsure.
1 minute, 6 seconds left in those roughing penalties. Carboneau and Bourne, and a false start on the faceoff, so they'll line up again. Very close checking here in the second period. The Canadiens have had 5 shots on Roland Melanson. The Islanders have had 3 shots on Rick Walmsley. Carboneau got it to Schutt. Gillies turned him around. The puck comes to the left side. Canadiens hold it in. Steve Schutt over to Picard. And his shot scooped up, cleared aside by Melanson to Bourne. Bob Born to Thomas Johnson. Now to Born. Born cuts to the left wing. Comes to center ice. Over the Montreal line. Bumped on the boards by Root. Shutt goes after the puck. Gilly slammed into him. Root and Born still battling for it. It came off the boards. Is loose back of the net. Picard for the Canadiens. Picking. Born had his helmet knocked off. And here comes Bill Root. Rudy likes to turn at the Montreal line. Sets up the play with a pass to Picard. Robert Picard over the line. Picard trying to walk in around Johnson, but he lost the puck, took the feet out from under Melanson. And Poffin pinned on the board. So stick went flying, and we'll get a face-off as the puck has been frozen. Poffin knocking it out of the hands of Shutt. Now Born and Shutt exchange some words.
It was Shutt who had a half a headlock on Born. That's how he lost his helmet. There you get a good look at Bob Born. See what he looks like without the headpiece. A little chippy the game in the period. When it gets close checking like this, players all seem to be bunched up at times. Contact is a little closer. More players come together. Words are exchanged. Little shoves and pushes. Bits of intimidation.
We watch Mondeau in the face-off against Merrick. Kinkaller, the Islander forwards, with Pearson and Langevin on defense, and this is Kaller coming up the right way. Pass to the left side to Merrick. Merrick's drive right into the catching glove of Walmsley. Threw it off in time, they rule, and out come the Canadiens. Mondeau leads the rush. Mondeau over the line. Pearson chases him wide, forced him back of the net. Puck at the side of the goal, and Melanson has held it there, and we'll get a face-off again. And again, some words exchanged. There is a break in the action. The score, with 8:59 to play, is the Islanders 2, the Canadiens 1. A good look as they line up with this face-off. Linesman Bob Luther dropping the puck between Mondeau and Merrick, and the Islanders control it in their own end of the ice. Pearson to Kaller. Anders Kaller into center. The team's at six aside again. Kaller to Merrick. His drive is deflected off Ludwig and into the crowd. The youngster behind the Montreal goal felt the full force of that one.
That's too bad. Hard shot deflected. The youngster sitting 10 or 12 rows up behind the Montreal net caught them. Hit the side of the head by the looks of his father's with him. Hopefully he'll be all right. Hate to see anybody get hit with that puck. It's hard and sharp.
Members of the St. John Ambulance Group move in. Well, they've been around hockey arenas in this country for years and years. The men in black and white.
At all events.
Now DeLorme back in the Montreal. He fights with the puck behind the net. Dealt it off to the left wing corner for Craig Ludwig. Ludwig shot went down into the Islanders zone. Pearson goes back, and that's an icing call against the Canadiens. The Islanders are back here in Montreal on March 1st. That'll be the third and final game of the regular season between these two teams. Don't think she got hit by the puck. It wasn't her, folks.
No.
You're just going to let me hang here, right?
Yeah, you're doing such a good job, Jakes. Go ahead. I was going to tell you that they got the puck that the young fellow was struck with and gave it to him. Hopefully that'll take a little of the pain out of getting hit.
School tomorrow, he'll be a hero with that thing, won't he?
Oh, yes. Wayne Merrick's shot deflected and hit him.
Now Goring sets up Nystrom, and he had it knocked off his stick as he went to shoot it. Lafleur overskated it. Poffin checking offside at the Montreal blue line.
Carbonell, a good defensive move as the Islanders catch Montreal napping a little in their own end of the ice. There he is, the great Guy Lafleur. Love to see him wind up and get going again. You know, I'm trying to urge him on, I guess, inside me, because I've seen him perform so many times so well. Controls the hockey game, or did, for many years.
Now Carbonell from Montreal hits Lafleur with a pass on right wing, a slap shot, Melanson to save. Poffin knocks it loose, Lafleur picks it up in deep, and a shot off Melanson and into the crowd, back of the net. So Melanson comes up big when called upon to block that man, number 10, Guy Lafleur.
Has the only goal for Montreal in the first period. What the heck I'm complaining about? He got a beautiful goal. Here he is again. Look at the balance as he swings quickly on his skates. Lets the shot go. You see the
puck bounce up off the stick of Roland Melanson. I think goaltenders, pros and cons. Here's LaFleur again from that high angle camera. Dennis Potvin goes down to cover the low ice, sliding, takes a little of the view away from the goaltender.
You wonder, would the California Seals, the Oakland Seals, still be alive had they been able to draft LaFleur back when, instead of having him go to the Canadiens? A shot blocked by Wamsley, comes loose. Tonelli knocked down on the play, comes back on the near side to the blue line and outside the line where Bossy picked it up. Bossy got away from Ganey, who was being tied up at the time. Morrow, now Nylon over the line, and Morrow knocks it away from him. To Trache on right wing. Trache slipped away from Nylon's check, dropped it back to McEwen. To Trache, to McEwen, up the right side, out of the reach of both Bossy and Tonelli. So here's Robinson, to Green. Rick Green, Ganey brought it in. He had his skates inside the Islander line, then brought the puck in offside.
Keith acting a little fast as he came across the line ahead of the puck. Ganey was looking for his teammates, and Acton snuck us before he could get the puck into position across the Islander blue line. Bob Ganey.
Just in case fans are confused when I'm talking about LaFleur and being drafted by Oakland, they had the draft rights to the number one junior, only they had traded them, given them up.
1971.
Made a deal with the Canadiens. 71, yeah. So the Canadiens, well, of course, the trade had been made prior to that. The future considerations, it turned out to be the draft pick in 71. Sam Pollock has done it. He knew that LaFleur would be draftable that year. And got it. Now Nylon taken off the puck by Tonelli. Pile up on the boards, and there's no further play in the Montreal end of the ice. That was one of Sam Pollock's better deals. He made so many for future considerations, draft choices, dealing off players who had a year or two left, perhaps, as far LA. As top caliber is concerned. Oh, yeah, L.A. would take anybody in those days.
You were in L.A., Jiggs. You saw a lot of that going on then. Los Angeles were missed for trading away their draft picks for players that were in their waning years as hockey players.
I remember one morning, as the team from Springfield, the Springfield Kings, were breaking training camp, the general manager down to the bus. It was about 6:30 in the morning as they were to leave, and he drew about four guys off the bus and said, "You're all going to Montreal." Doug Robinson was one of them. At the moment, don't recall who all made it, but there was a wholesale change with the Canadiens. And there was the big deal for Rogie Vachon, Backstrom, so many others. Picard has shot the puck into the crowd behind the Islander goal. We have 6:51 remaining in the second period. Well, we'll be in Los Angeles a week from tonight. We'll have that game for you at 10:30 Eastern Time on WOR-TV, the Islanders and the Kings, third meeting of the year. And then on Saturday night, the Islanders and the Vancouver Canucks from Pacific Coliseum, the shore Pacific Ocean.
Yes, and up behind the beautiful Pacific Ocean are the beautiful Rocky Mountains. And you're going to go skiing, right?
Well, I'm going to watch the mountains anyway, see if I recognize skiers.
We'll get you on the skis, Jiggs. You got to try that. That's it.
I'll pose as a tree. How's that?
You don't have enough limbs. You have the trunk.
Yeah, oh, yes. I think we'll just drop it right there, if you don't mind.
All right.
Warren won the face of the Islanders, getting it to Pearson, to Langevin, back to Bourne, now to Gillies. Islanders leading it 2-1 as Gillies dumped it into the corner. Helene was taken off the right wing side, couldn't get to the corner in time, and out to center ice comes Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser passed it to Walter, and his shot was off Stefan Pearson and into the crowd. Well, the game has really tightened into a defensive battle here now. The Islanders with a 2-1 lead. They've had a couple of penalties, coincidental penalties at 8:54 of the period, and that's been just about it. Montreal has had 7 shot goal. The Islanders have had 5. All the scoring in the first period.
Roland Melanson showing no effects of his first period collision with Chris Nylon.
Canadiens won the draw, got it back to Picard, over to Root, shot off the catching glove of Melanson, dives on top of it, and smothers it. Fans here in Montreal wanted him to keep the play going, but Roland not exactly sure where it was or how it was coming off of him. They elected
They're getting
smother.
A little restless here in Montreal, Jiggs. They're used to maybe the something like we saw in the first period. They wanted to see that throughout the whole hockey game. I'm sure Andy Van Helleman would probably prefer it that way. when the teams are skating hard and moving the puck, it's a much easier, much better hockey game. Montreal does not want to turn loose the offensive power of the Islanders. The Islanders, of course, as Bill Torrey mentioned in our interview, they'd like to exploit the weak defense of Montreal, their young, inexperienced defense. As it turns out, it's Green and Robinson, the veteran defensemen, that are having the most trouble.
Now Merrick has cleared it back of the Montreal goal. Delorme and Keller go to the boards together. It overcame Brent Sutter. Merrick is there. They try to freeze it. It was knocked loose by Naslund. Brent Sutter giving a push. Mondu picked up the puck. Checked by Brent Sutter. Sutter and Delorme chase it to the corner. Here's Keller now. Anders Keller all the way to the blue line. Trying to turn inside. Naslund. Then Randy Delorme and was knocked down for his efforts. The puck is shot high up into the crowd. Greg Ludwig trying to clear it out. Instead, shot it into the crowd. Well, Saturday night, the Islanders and the Philadelphia Flyers at the Nassau Coliseum, and then the Islanders hit the road for five straight games.
There's Delorme's check on Anders Keller. A good one. Delorme showing some of his strength. Gilbert Delorme. Second pick, 18th overall in 81 for the Montreal Canadiens.
Now Goring and Mondu on the faceoff. Goring is out with Gilbert and Nystrom for the Islanders. Johnson and Potvin on defense. Goring waved out of the faceoff area. Mondu had to leave as well, so it'll be Gilbert taking the draw against Naslund. Randy Mitten, the linesman, backs the Canadiens up a little. The puck came back to Johnson. A drive off the post to the left of Wansley. Delorme cleared it to center ice. That's Potvin back. To Goring on the left side. Backhands it around the boards. Wamsley with Nystrom on top of him. The Islanders knocked it away from the goaltender. Comes right to the side of the net. And Canadiens cover up back of the net. Naslund to the line, but not out. Here's Denny Potvin to Goring. Goring a drive, and that changed direction in front of the net. Johnson pokes it to the corner. Ludwig and Nystrom bump heavily. Ludwig came up with the puck. Got it to the left wing. Mondu rink wide to Tremblay. Delorme takes over at center ice. Delorme, a defenseman, leads the attack. Gave it to Tremblay, and his shot was blocked by Melanson. Nystrom cleared it around to Thomas Johnson. We have 5 minutes in the second period. Nystrom back to Johnson. Johnson checked back of his own goal. Recovers the puck. Naslund chases him again. Johnson to Nystrom. He was checked, but Potvin picked it up. Up the right side, but out of the reach of Bob Nystrom, and it's poked back into the Islanders' zone. Denny Potvin on the left side. Didn't make a play with it. Carbonell moved it to the left side. And Johnson moved over to knock shut down. There'll be a penalty coming up. Shot centers, Trotsky gets control of it, and the Canadiens are going to the power play.
The vehicle they used to score their first goal back in the first period, the power play. Steve Schott off the bench as Montreal were changing while play was in motion. Schott off the bench, made a foot race with Thomas Johnson, and Johnson pulled him down. Gets the penalty. Power play now by Montreal.
15:29 will be the time of this penalty. Bob Berry, the Montreal coach, has Carbonell, Lafleur, and Schutt as his forwards, with Green and Robinson on defense. A hooking penalty against Johnson. It is Trache, Bourne, Langevin, and Persson for the Islanders. Persson knocked the puck away from Lafleur, and Trache clears it into the Montreal zone. Born into forecheck as Robinson is back for the puck around to Green. Rick Green returns it to Robinson. Larry Robinson takes a look for the winger. This case, Lafleur, and the pass went off his stick, controlled by Keller. Keller to Born, intercepted by Lafleur. Lafleur comes over the line, gave it to Carbonell. He shoots, and that was off the target. Now shot on the left wing, and it's stolen by Keller, and he has cleared it down into the Montreal end of the ice. A minute 24 remaining in the penalty to Johnson. Robinson waits for his teammates to come back. Canadiens fans want him to move it quicker. Got it to Lafleur. Lafleur back to Robinson. Over the Islander line. Robin to Lafleur. Lafleur center, shot with a shot that went wide. The rebound was cleared out of the reach of Guy Carbonell. Comes out of the corner, picked off by Langevin. Dave Langevin checked from behind. Lafleur stole it, couldn't do anything with it on the first attempt. Now comes off the boards, poked it into the corner. He and Persson tie it up together. It's dug loose. and shot, or Carbonell rather, was knocked down. Ersan has dumped it down inside the Montreal line. 40 seconds left in the penalty. Hit green into center ice to Mondu. Checked by Bourne. Now Naslin gets a stick on it. Comes in around Morrow. Naslin centers and tries to score. Mondu.
You can hear the ovation here in Montreal as the Montreal Canadiens strike for the second time on the power play. There's the pass. And it's in the net. Pierre Mondu. Ken Morrow loses a half a step to Carbonell. Quick pass to Mondu, and it's in the lower right-hand corner. The game is tied at two apiece.
Mondu gets his 15th of the season. Well, the power play in Montreal had been none too healthy. The Islanders had killed 18 in a row, but are stung. Back-to-back power play goals by the Canadiens. Naslund gets an assist.
It was one. His speed on the outside, getting partially around Ken Morrow, that made the opening for Mondu.
So it reads Mondu from Naslund and Green at the 17-minute mark. And we're brand new 2-2 tie. 2:52 left to play in the second period. Again, I remind fans that tickets for the All-Star Game to be played at the Nassau Coliseum on Tuesday, February 8th will go on sale at the Coliseum box office Saturday morning at 10:30. Purchases of 4 tickets per person. Morrow and McEwen on the Islander defense. Bossy, Trache, and Gilbert up front. Greg Gilbert bumped by Ganey. And Acton has forced the Islanders to go back. McEwen back of the net. To the right side, gave the pass to Bossy. Bossy dumps it into center ice, and here's Greg Gilbert trying to come in around Robinson. Gilbert moves in, and he shot it wide as Robinson bumped behind. Ganey clears it up the left side. Nyland can't control it. Trache for the Islanders, over to McEwen. Michael McEwen blasts one into the corner. Bob Ganey goes back. Trache in after the puck. Around the boards, Bossy was checked by Robinson. Ganey gets a stick on it, gave it to Robinson. To Acton on left wing, couldn't make contact with it. And it's loose at the Islander line. That's Trache. Trache to McEwen. McEwen shoots it into the Montreal zone. It ends up on left wing for Walter. Ryan Walter, the former Washington Capitals. Neat pass. Wickenheiser trying to get in around Pearson, was chased to the corner. Aline moved into that area as well. The puck came off the boards at center. Gilly stepped in front of Picard, and Langevin has dumped it to center ice. Coming back, Canadiens at their own line. Ludwig to Napier. Napier's pass for Wickenheiser was tipped down into the Islander zone. Pearson went back, trying to set up Brent Sutter on the right side. That failed to work. Picard from the blue line, and his shot went off Brent Sutter. A chance for the Canadiens. Napier shot, he scored! Napier!
Their hockey here in Montreal. Mark Napier has given them their second reason to cheer here in the second period. As Montreal find a couple of holes in the Islander defense, there's the shot by Napier just inside the goalpost to the right of Roland Melanson. And it's now 3-2 Montreal. We look again at the shot just inside the post. A beauty as the Islanders run into defensive problems in their own end of the ice.
Napier's 22nd goal of the season at 18:41. The Canadiens have scored 3 unanswered goals after the Islanders have built themselves a 2-0 lead.
And number 24, Robert Picard.
Wickenheiser and Picard get the assist. Canadiens into the Islanders zone again. A shot from the point kicked aside by Melanson. So the Canadiens come back. Napier shooting it into the Islander zone. Thomas Janssen with it back of the net. Janssen to the blue line. The puck was up on edge. Got it to Merrick. Slaps it around the boards. We watch Delorme recover back of the net with 37 seconds left in the second period. It comes out on the right side for Wickenheiser. Cuts to the left. At center ice, shot it into the Islander zone. The Canadiens head for a player change. Janssen with 25 seconds left. The puck to Poffin. Up left wing to Greg Gilbert, to Nystrom over the line, the pass to Merrick.
Can't get in through the defense. Naslund teamed up with Green on the play. Now Naslund into the corner to Green. Merrick on top of him took him to the boards. Nystrom steps into Naslund. And the puck is frozen for a faceoff in the Montreal zone.
Montreal started to skate, Jiggs. You could see them pick up the tempo when Tomas Janssen got a hooking penalty. With their skating effort, they got the goal. They kept on pressing. They skated much better since then.
Now about this note, the Islanders have not trailed at any time during this win streak. They've led for 327 minutes and 24 seconds and have been tied for 32 minutes and 36 seconds. First time that they've trailed since New Year's night in Pittsburgh.
I'm glad you had that stat. Man, I still don't know what that meant.
I got a translation guide for
327 minutes plus that they have led. Only 32 minutes that they've been tied.
You got it.
Wow. Okay.
And during the stretch of six games without a loss, it never trailed. Okay.
During
one second left in this period.
Second intermission, the great Red Fisher. Going to talk with what a lot of people feel is one of the greatest hockey authorities in Canada. Talked to him before on Channel 9, Red Fisher.
And there's the siren entering the second period. The Canadiens get two unanswered goals and scored three in a row. And at the end of two periods, our score, Montreal Canadiens 3, the New York Islanders 2. We'll have a recap of the period following these messages.
Peppered Billy Saul Hargis.
That's not him, that's Bob Berry. I'm referring to Don Imus, WC. He'll be the master of ceremonies. Bob Berry will be 40 in November.
He looks about 63 right there, doesn't he?
For many years, number 18 of the Los Angeles Kings.
He had a couple of nicknames, Fugitive, Poor Soul, a few others.
He may be able to carry them on here.
He might be. We watch Robinson come over the Islander line with a slap shot that went wide on the glove side, and Melanson covers up on it. He came to the side of the net. Canadians weren't covered to a man, so Melanson elected to get the face off. I was only kidding about Bob Berry. Well, seriously, he will be 40 next November, but he has aged. He'd be the first to admit it since coming here. There's a degree of pressure above anywhere else in the National Hockey League when it comes to the coaching job of the Canadiens. If you doubt my word, ask Bernie Jeffrion. Or you can ask several people for that matter. The puck loose in front of the Islander goal and picked off by Janssen. Thomas Janssen to Bossy. Bossy, rink wide. That's Tinelli on the left side, trying to get in around Robinson. Tinelli picks up the puck again. Made the play to Bossy, and his shot went off the skate of Green. Trache races after it. To Bossy, out in front. Tinelli too well covered. It got away from Poffin as well, and Trache hustles back. Off the boards, it goes right to Robinson. For the Islander line, another slap shot. This one off Melanson's stick. Michael Bossy on the right wing. Gave the puck to Trache, and he backhands it high into the Montreal zone. Robinson chased to the corner by Gillies, and the puck is cleared to Picard. Robert Picard tried to feed Wickenheiser. Helene tied him up. This is Langevin. Back to Mats Helene. Helene gives it to Gillies, to Bourne. Bourne over center ice, three Canadiens back. Bourne got over the line working on Bill Root. Put it out in front. Helene was checked off the puck. Gillies followed through but couldn't get there in time, and it's loose at center ice. Stefan Persson to Langevin. Waited for Helene to get back onside, and then waited too long, and the Islanders go in offside. A break.
Tremblay à Carbonneau et Melançon retient disque le long.
Back live from the Forum in Montreal. The Canadiens applying some pressure. Yonki Carbonneau tested Melançon, and he was able to make a save and kick the puck away, and it came back to the side of the net. We get a break in the action now. 16:28 to play in the game. The score remains Canadiens 3, the Islanders 2.
3-2, Montreal leading the New York Islanders. We apologize again for the technical problem we've experienced. Hopefully everything is corrected now. The Canadiens are out shooting the Islanders 24-12. We have just over 16 minutes to play. The lady that you just saw, Mrs. Guy Lafleur. And here's Gainey with a shot that was just wide of the Islander net. Acton and Poffin tied up on the boards.
came out of Fafan's gates, right back into them, and there's no further play.
Jiggs, Pierre Mondeau had been taken to the Montreal dressing room. He hurt himself. He fell awkwardly at center ice and went down, kind of crawled off the ice, got some help from his teammates. They took him to the dressing room. Appeared he injured his left leg. We're not exactly sure what the injury is. We'll try and find out. Mondeau, who scored the second goal for Montreal in the second period.
Now Robinson off the point. The shot tipped by Acton and wide. Janssen has it. Thomas Janssen sends Trache up the right wing. Gave the puck to Bossy. Bossy over the line, trying to cut to the inside. Handled it well. Gave it to Potvin. Around, moves in deep. Went to center when it was blocked at the side of the goal. Here's Green. Rick Green sends Acton over center ice. Gainey coming up with him. Acton drops it back. Nylund a shot. That hit Potvin. Danny Potvin back of the goal. Into the corner to Trache. Trache rink wide to Thomas Janssen. Has Bossy. Bossy takes the pass. Comes in on right wing. Faked the shot. Trying to walk in around Green. Gave it to Tonelli and he was too well covered. Green to LaFleur. Checked by Trache. Trache had to poke it out over the line. However, Langevin has it there. Langevin around the boards. Cut off by Wansley. Left it for Green. Out of LaFleur. LaFleur, rink wide, it's stolen by Brent Sutter. Brent Sutter plays one back of the net. Wansley left it for Robinson. Robinson passed it out of the reach of Gainey. Bearson at center to Brent Sutter. Over to Kaller. Kaller with a slap shot off the blocking glove of Wansley. Picked up by Robinson. Merrick knocked the puck away from him. Robinson recovers, plays it up left wing to Gainey, and Pearson pinched in on the boards to knock from him. So Robinson and Kaller go back of the net. Now Green takes over. Rick Green banks it off the boards into the Islanders zone. Langevin will hustle after it, and the Canadiens are called for icing.
Play a little sloppy. Islanders trying to put the pressure on that we've talked about in Montreal's end of the ice. Aaron passes. Rick Green shooting it down the ice. Guy LaFleur, how about him making a rink wide pass inside his own blue line, handing it right to the Islanders. Things that became can become very costly in a close hockey game. Islanders trailing Montreal now by one goal.
Saturday morning at 10:30, tickets for the annual All-Star game to be held at the Coliseum on Tuesday, February 8th, will go on sale to the public. Limited to 4 tickets per purchaser. They're priced at $30, $25, and $20 on sale at the Coliseum only, 10:30 Saturday morning. Carbonell leads the rush for Montreal after the Islanders had had a shot blocked at the side of the net. LaFleur bounced one in front of by Melanson, came out and cleared it ahead to Helene. Helene shoots it into the Montreal end of the ice, and this will go for icing. So we'll get a face-off in the Islanders zone. And I want to remind you, too, of the number for information on the All-Star Dinner tickets. Proceeds to assist juvenile diabetes. The number is area code 212-889-2244. Don Imus will be the master of ceremonies. Ann Murray and other entertainers will be on hand Monday night, February at the Coliseum.
You know what happened 52 weeks ago tonight? 52 weeks ago tonight.
I have no earthly idea.
Yep, the New York Islanders defeated. They destroyed the Penguins at the Coliseum 6-1. But that's not all. That began the historic 15-game winning streak that ended by the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Gillies hauled down by Schutt at center ice. No penalty call. Gillies dove off his skates trying to get attention of referee Van Helleman. We get a break in the action here with 13:56 left in the game. And the score, Canadiens 3, Islanders 2.
Penalty call on it. Did you think that maybe Clark went off the end of the board? He doesn't do that. I don't think so.
I think he didn't anticipate Schutt getting the way he did, and Schutt tried to make it look accidental, and he handled his part of the play very well, too. It's 3-2 Montreal. Nystrom being tied up by Delorme. Greg Gilbert in. Score forward, and it's frozen on the boards to the right of the Canadiens' goal. So the faceoff will be in the circle to the right. Wickenheiser is at center ice for Montreal. That is Gilbert Delorme. Delorme, one of the top players in the Emory Edge Award. As far as plus-minus is concerned, you can see why watching him here tonight. He's up the ice a great deal, making things happen for Montreal. Ludwig and DeLorme on the Canadiens' defense. DeLorme off the boards. Gilbert couldn't control it. Knocked it away from Wickenheiser. And here's Goring. Played it to the open wing. Nystrom comes up. Nystrom couldn't knock it away from the Montreal defenseman. Walter played it back to Ludwig. Ludwig off the boards to Walter. He stepped into Janssen, or Janssen stepped into him, I should say. And it's cleared by Puffin to Goring. Goring tried to set up Nystrom. Napier knocked it out of the air. Wickenheiser lost it to Gilbert. Gilbert, in turn, lost it to Napier, and it's loose inside the Allender line. Thomas Janssen dumps it into center ice. Knocked down. DeLorme, a long shot. Melanson, the stick save, and Puffin will pick it up. Little less than 13 minutes remaining in the game. Islanders trail by a goal as Nystrom comes over the line with a slap shot. Wamsley, the save, then cleared it off to Green. Green up that right side. Trombley put it right on Bossy's stick. Bossy forcing the Canadiens back. Robinson chased by Trache. They bumped together. Trache came up with the puck. Got it to Bossy. Trombley knocked it away from him. It goes to the right wing. Tonelli came over and put it up into the crowd.
Final score, Jigs. Calgary got another goal from Bridgman, but it was not enough. The Flyers defeated them 5-2.
So the Flyers win for the 29th time. They now have 64 points. And if the Islanders can't pull out a victory here tonight when they meet Saturday at the Nassau Coliseum, the Flyers will be 7 ahead of the Islanders. Flyer record 29-36. The Islanders came in here tonight at 25-16-7. In a week tonight, the Islanders will be in Los Angeles. That game for you right here on WOR, 10:30 New York time. Pearson to Tonelli. Tonelli trying to sneak in around Gainey at the Montreal line. Gave the puck to Pearson to Posse. He shoots. Blocked. Trache, the rebound, and it went over top of the net. Trache from back of the goal to the point for Pearson. He shoots. Blocked by Wamsley. Trache after the rebound. Tonelli feeds it to Langevin. Langevin's drive is blocked. And the rebound goes Gainey. Islanders apply some pressure, but the Canadiens withstand it. And now the puck. There to Langevin on left wing. Long pass. Posse has it at the Montreal line. Back to Pearson. To Trache. Trache trying to cut in on the backhand. Couldn't do it. Comes off the boards. Gave it to Tonelli. Shoots. Blocked by Wamsley. Play is called, and there will be a penalty to the Canadiens. A break in the action. 11:22 left in the hockey game. Islanders go to the power play with the score. And 3, Islanders 2.
A penalty to Rick Green. See him pull John Tonelli down. He goes to the penalty box with an interference penalty. Islanders putting on great pressure, have a power play opportunity. A final score. Boston has done it again. Peters gets a shutout. They beat Buffalo 4-0. Fergus, Bruce Crowder, Middleton, and Keith Crowder all scoring for Boston in another shutout for Peters.
What a year he is having. Here's Bob Bourne walking in a backhander. He scores! Bourne right from the faceoff ties it up. 4 seconds into the penalty against Green. He went off at 8:38. Bourne scores at 8:42.
Right from the faceoff. There's Bourne. He gets the puck back. A backhand shot into the lower right-hand corner. Beats Walmsley. Kaller raises his arms. Let's look again. There's Bourne as he gets the puck from the faceoff and puts it in the lower right-hand corner and ties the hockey game. Bob Bourne scoring. That's his 10th goal of the season. A backhand shot, a power play goal, and the Islanders tie the game at 3.
That on the right side of the Montreal defense assisting Bourne on that goal, but unassisted at 8:42. Bob Bourne gets into the double digits, his 10th of the season. He leads the Islanders back into the Montreal end of the ice. Brent Sutter chased it to the corner. It slammed on the boards. Comes up with the puck, however, knocking it away from DeLorme. Overcomes Merrick. Merrick going back to the goal. Ran into Ludwig, and Merrick went down. Now Brent Sutter takes care of Ludwig. Came off the boards, then was checked. Wickenheiser kicks it out over the line to Napier. Mark Napier, twisting and turning at center ice, has forced the Islanders to go back, and then he and Brent Sutter collided heavily, and Sutter spins off the boards as Wickenheiser played for the Islander goal. Napier chasing it. Janssen stepped in front of him. Make it Walter, rather, not Napier. Walter checked on the boards, and there's no further play. We have 10:22 left in the game, and the hitting becomes more prevalent.
sparks a little bit of skating by both teams. Mark Napier and Brent Sutter. Sutter goes after him. Napier rebounds off the boards. Boom. Oops. Bang. Hard to balance going backwards.
Boy, you really got all the off-the-wall stuff here tonight.
Well, we're getting some great camera shots. Oh, this?
Yeah.
Islanders are unbeaten this season. They're 9-0-2 when they score at least two power play goals.
Well,
bet you didn't know that.
They have two power play. No, one power play goal here tonight. Make it two.
Two in the first period. Yes.
Bourne here in the third. Canadians also have two power play goals. Picard shot. Stick saved by Malone. Borrell cleared the rebound to Bourne. Out to Gillies. Gillies comes over the line. Helene cut to the inside. Gillies went after it again. Got it to Bourne. He and Helene tied up. It comes out to Gillies. Gillies put it back in the net. Lafleur and Bourne chasing it. And Carbonneau back for Montreal. Checked in the corner. That's Helene. Helene to Bourne. Out in front to Gillies. And he was checked at the last second. Here's Helene. Moves into backhander. He scores! That's Helene. Scores in the 4 minutes. A happy hockey player.
Montreal had possession of the puck. Lafleur couldn't hang on to it. The Islanders take it away. There's Gillies miscuing on a chance. Get the stick on the puck, but Mats Helin fights a rolling, bouncing puck, and then a backhand shot. Looked like he could have got a little help from Bourne. Let's look again. There's Bourne to Gillies. Missed on the shot. Robert Picard, number 24, tried to cover him. Root tries to get after Mats Helin, but he beats Walmsley with another backhand shot. Islanders have regained their lead, 4-3.
So Helin, it's his second of the year. Gillies an assist, along with Bourne, and the Islanders are in, knocking at the door again. The goal at 10:08 as the Islanders up again, 4-3. The puck now in the Islanders zone. Naslin in after it. Langevin back for the Islanders. Gave it to Goring. To Gilbert, just out of his reach. Nystrom moved up. Couldn't get there in time. Trombley fed it to the right wing. It was blocked by Lonta. Nystrom. Nystrom gets away from Trombley. Comes over the line on right wing. Nystrom centers, and it was cleared at the defense. DeLorme blocking that pass. Goring stays inside the blue line, then lost it. Up comes Naslin. Naslin over the Islander line. It was knocked off his stick and cleared by Goring. Ludwig at center ice. Shot it to the Islander zone, and the Canadians put it in offside. A break in the action. 8:55 left in the hockey game. The score, the New York Islanders 4, the Montreal Canadiens 3. The Canadiens are just in with a great scoring opportunity that was broken up at the side of the net, and now Tinelli has dumped the puck into the Montreal zone. We watch Robinson controlling it to Acton. It was Acton and Gainey who had the chance for Montreal a moment ago. Bossy, Tinelli, and Trottier forced the Canadiens back. Green over to Robinson. Larry Robinson up the left side off Gainey's stick at center ice. Keith Acton got over the line. Trottier bothering him, and Nylund had stepped across the line offside.
Opportunity, Jiggs, for Montreal to tie the game. You know, I've watched and watched and watched, and over the years, there's something that's inherent in hockey players. If you're a defensive style player like Bob Gainey, the reason he missed that goal was he was backing up. He was thinking more defensively. He had an opportunity. Roland Melanson was down off the first save. He was down and out of the play. Gainey, the rebound, was backing up. He lost his balance, did not get the shot away. He could have easily put it over Roland Melanson and into the open net, but it didn't happen. He looked defensive in an offensive situation.
Now we watch McEwen come up for the Islanders. Into center ice, Michael McEwen's long shot was wide. Walmsley covers it as it came off the boards and forces a face-off. Not dressed for the Islanders tonight, Paul Boutelier and Gord Lane. Wayne Sutter and Billy Carroll not dressed. Two defensemen and two forwards sitting out.
Do you know, Jiggs, that if you were sitting at the north end of the Montreal Forum tonight, you'd have seen 6 of the 7 goals scored far.
Okay.
Yeah, and Daryl Sittler recorded his 1,000th point in the National Hockey League tonight in that 5-1 win over Calgary.
And that qualifies him automatically for the National Hockey League's Milestone Award.
Yes, it does.
Watch Ludwig come to center ice. The pass to Walter.
Ryan Walter over to the right wing. Napier shot off Melanson's glove, off the post, and into the far corner. Wickenheiser checked by Merrick, then knocked down, but has cleared it. It goes over the glass and into the crowd.
Close call. Team starting to put the pressure on. 7:36 remaining here in the third period. The Islanders, who fell behind, had retied and then regained their lead. Al Arbor has to feel a little more refreshed. If he doesn't, he can walk out. There's Irv Grundman.
He is the general manager of the Montreal Canadiens. One of the rumors we heard this week was that his job was in jeopardy. And he may take it prior to that and relieve Bob Berry of his duties. That was the story. But the people here in Montreal say no truth to that. But you never know. It's usually when statements like that are made and denied that you can expect something to happen.
Rumors. The rumor mill.
I have to start the rumor of the night on these games.
Well, we could easily do that.
Okay, go ahead. Walter taken off the puck by Pearson, and Langevin moves it to the left side for Gillies. Out of Bourne, can't get out of there. Clark Gillies picks up the puck, carries it up left wing. At center ice, shot it wide of the Montreal goal. Robert Picard, they rule it was icing as Gillies apparently shot it from his own side of the center ice strike.
I did start a rumor tonight. You were going skiing. That's the new president of the Montreal Canadiens. I think that's him. He was here earlier when we were talking with Bob Berry.
Yes, I believe it is.
If the Island go on to win tonight, Jiggs, it'll be the first time since October 7, 8, and 11. The Islanders have won two straight on the road. Starting to get back to some of their stats back that they had been missing for a couple of months.
You were right. That was Mr. Corey, the president of the Canadiens, that you saw on your screen a moment ago. Puck, in the meantime, ends up in the Montreal territory. Root bumped in the corner. That's Gillies, along with Bourne in forechecking. Helene headed to the front of the puck had been tied up. 6:52 left in the hockey game.
Mario Tremblay, number 14. Montreal's fourth pick. Back in 1974, 12th overall that year. Good skater, good shooter.
He sure is.
He's a rugged player, not very big, but he's aggressive.
So Goring gets set for this faceoff. We're in the circle to the right of the Montreal goal. And that's Mondu, who had limped off the ice earlier, ready to take the draw for the Canadiens. Mondu got a stick on it to Tremblay, to Delorme. Delorme given a bump by Gilbert. It comes up the left side. Naslin checked by Janssen. The puck loose for Gilbert. Couldn't control it as he tried to come out of the corner. And here's Tremblay. Mario Tremblay had it knocked off his stick. Greg Gilbert knocked it away from Delorme. Goring feeds it to Nystrom over the Montreal line. Nystrom turns, tried to make the play to Goring, but he had been chased away. And back comes Naslin. Naslin over the Islander line, trying to cut in around Janssen. Is chased back of the net. Knocked off the puck. Nystrom falling, couldn't clear it out. Here's Naslin again. Janssen steps in front of him a second time. Nystrom can't knock it away from Tremblay. Puts it off to the side of the net, a scramble, and Nystrom comes out of there with it. Bob Nystrom fired it into center ice. Ludwig for Montreal to Naslin, and he's forced the Islanders to go back. In 6 minutes left in the game, Janssen around the boards, held in by Schutt. Steve Schutt is checked. It came back to Carbonneau. Trache upends him, and there'll be an Islander penalty on the play. Trache stuck the stick between his legs and brought him down, and Montreal, who is 2-for-2 on the power play, gets a chance now.
5 minutes and 49 seconds remaining in the third period. Islanders leading 4-3, and Dennis Potvin gets the nod of the referee. Tripping penalty. Looked like it was going to be Jake.
Strachey, then.
Let's take a look.
Well, we'll do that in a moment. I'll remind you right now that our next game for you on WOR-TV, 1 week from tonight, 10:30 New York time, the Islanders and the Los Angeles Kings. And then on Saturday, the 29th, we'll be in Vancouver for a game against the Vancouver Canucks. Poffhand is getting the penalty. Watch Trachey here.
There's Trachey. Boom.
Well, Poffin had a stick one. Out on the other. Yeah.
Give it to both or either one. Somebody's going to get it anyway.
It's Poffin for tripping. And Trache does.
Robinson again jigs as he lets the player get too close to him. Ryan Trache knocking the puck away.
Here's shot over the Allender line. Drops it back. Ryan Walter moves in, takes a shot. That was wide. 5:25 left in the hockey game. More importantly, the Canadians on a power play, and they're in the Allender end of the ice. This is Ryan Walter. Pearson took him boards. The puck went loose. LaFleur with it. He LaFleur to Green. Green shot to a screen. Melanson has made the save. It was in his chest protector. Drops into the top of the pads, and he holds it.
Billy Smith looks on as he watches Roland Melanson make a good save. Part of being a good goaltender, being in the right place at the right time. Billy Smith getting somebody a hockey stick. Roland Melanson moved over. He could see Green positioning himself to take the shot. A lot of traffic in front of him, so he moved to that side of the net, stood there. The puck hit him.
Trache will take the faceoff against Walter. McEwen and Morrow on defense, Goring and Trache up front. Walter shot to LaFleur for the Canadiens. Walter got the draw to LaFleur. He shoots and it was tipped wide. Walter races to the corner. Back to Robinson at the right point. In along the boards. McEwen got a piece of it. It's dug off the boards by Schutt. His drive. Morrow. Melanson did a tap dance at the side of the net. It comes out in front. A scramble. The puck's underneath McEwen, then under Melanson, and smothered for a faceoff. Close call. A scramble in front of the net.
But the puck Islanders is close. The players are trying to corral it. The Islanders, that is. Montreal are trying to shoot it in the net. They want to keep the puck in motion at that point. As Schutt bounced it out in front of the net. There's Schutt, number 22, bouncing it off the skates. Melanson got his feet crossed up. The puck was under him for a moment. Then loose. McEwen tried to get down on top of it. But you see the left hand of Roland Melanson as he reaches out with number 22, Rod Schutt, moving in looking for the loose puck. Melanson beat him to it.
1 minute and 3 seconds left in the penalty to Poffin. Carboneau on the draw, came right back to Carboneau, and McEwen knocked it off his stick. They end up on the boards together. LaFleur jabbed it loose. McEwen clears it up the right wing, and Trache has banked it off the boards into the Montreal zone. Going back is Green. Islanders 4, Canadiens 3. The fans want the Canadiens to hustle up the power play. Green to Robinson. Robinson overskated it. Now Green shoots it in wide of Melanson. Carboneau in after it. Carboneau around one check. Back to Schutt. Schutt is checked by Goring, and the Canadiens have to chase it. 25 seconds left of the penalty. Here is Green. Bourne and Caller, the Islander forwards, now as Green has shot it into the far corner. Langevin banks it off the boards, and again, the Canadiens are forced back. 12 seconds remaining in the Montreal power play. It comes around the boards, stolen by Bourne, into Caller. Anders Caller, checked by Green, and the Canadiens start out the penalty about to expire, and they're back at six aside. Naslund over the line. Naslund in deep, put it off to the side of the net. It hit Pearson, comes down in front again, and Stefan Pearson brings it to safety. Gave the puck to Bourne. Bourne with a goal and an assist here in the third period to get the Islanders both even and into the lead. 3 minutes and 29 seconds to play in the game. Trombley at center ice. Over the Islander line, has shot it into the corner. Mondeau in to pick it up. Pierre Mondeau back to Ludwig. Ludwig from the point, is shot blocked by Melanson. Big rebound. Trombley checked by Langevin. And Merrick picks it up, gives it to Nystrom. To the line, but not out. Delorme shot hit Mondeau. Comes loose to the near corner. Pearson for the Islanders. Takes a look, fires it down the ice. This will be called for icing, but we're inside the 3 minute, the final period. A break in the action. Well, let's tell you about the National Hockey League All-Star game again. Tickets will go on sale to the public Saturday morning at 10:30 at the Nassau Coliseum. The game will be played the night of Tuesday, February 8th. A limited number of good tickets available at $30, $25, or $20. Purchases restricted to a maximum allotment of 4 tickets. Tickets will only be sold at the Coliseum main ticket lobby. There will be no Ticketron sale for this event. You'll see the likes of Wayne Gretzky, Michael Bossy, many, many more performing for their respective conferences, the Campbell and Prince of Wales Conference in the annual All-Star Game. With 21 teams, it'll be a long time before the Islanders host it again. So if you don't have tickets, they'll go on sale Saturday morning, 10:30 at the Nassau Coliseum. Rache to face off against Ryan Walter after Wickenheiser had been waved out. 2 minutes and 57 seconds left. The Islanders led it at 1 point, 2-0, then trailed 3-2, or up. The Canadiens' Napier was just robbed by Melanson. Islanders lead it 4-3, and here's Bossy with a break. Over the Montreal line, Bossy couldn't cut in around Green. Bossy got a stick on it again to Tonelli, who's checked back of the net. Over comes Trotche. Ryan Trotche gets tangled up between Wickenheiser and Green. Bossy played it around the boards, but right to Green. To Walter, and he dumps it up left wing. Here's a break for her. Potvin hustles back. Napier in deep, shoots, he scores!
He had an excellent opportunity a moment ago, and he was robbed blind by Roland Melanson. And here he comes back again. Fake the shot. Potvin is after him, but his second move, he puts it into the lower part of the net. As Roland Melanson guessed right there, he guessed coming out. Napier smartly held on to the puck and beat he and Potvin. Let's look again at the fake shot, and then he blows the lower part of the net, and the game is tied again at 4 apiece. Mark Napier, a sigh of relief for Irv Grumman, the president, the general manager of the Montreal Canadiens. Got to make him breathe a little easier.
Napier at 17:35, his second goal of this game. Walter gets an assist along with Rick Green. The Canadiens back into the Islanders' zone. The puck cleared out by Helene. Back for it, Bill Root. Root plays it up the middle of the ice right to Morrow, to Gillies off his skates. It's controlled by Carbonell. Ernie Carbonell comes over the line. His drive off the stick and up into the crowd. Rookie has performed well. And the Canadiens, you know, you look at Carbonell now, you look at Wickenheiser, the way he has played tonight, their patience has really paid off with him. Wickenheiser, I mean.
That's one of the usherettes or hostesses here at the Montreal Forum. Look at the determination of Bob Bourne as he gets ready for the faceoff against Keith Acton.
Just inside the Islander line, Gillies on the left, Helene on the right. Acton, Lafleur, and Gainey, and the draw comes out to center ice for Picard. Long shot, stick save by Melanson. McEwen with it, comes from back of the net up the right side. First pass was blocked, and then he's able to clear it to the Montreal line. Less than 2 minutes to play in the game. Morrow at a blue line, ahead for Bourne. It was up in the air, and Picard controls it. Robert Picard over center ice to Lafleur. Make the slap shot as he tries to come in on the right wing. McEwen stepped in front of him and overcomes Morrow. Around the boards and out into center ice. Rick Green inside the Montreal line. Gave it to Robinson. Robinson, the pass out of the reach of Acton. Walter and Morrow chase it to the corner. Danny Morrow off the boards. It's controlled by Goring. Goring and Gilbert come to center ice. Gilbert tipping it in the Montreal zone. Green picked. Plays it off to the right wing to Napier. A long pass to Acton, out of his reach. Chased to the boards by Janssen. Acton back on his skates, but the play has been called. We have 1 minute and 6 seconds left in the game.
Neither team wants to settle for a tie. They're going to battle it right down to the final buzzer. 1 minute and 6 seconds remaining. What started out to be a tremendous hockey game, lulled a little bit in the second period, picked up at the end of the second period, and has had brief stints here in the third, off and on.
It was 2-1 Islanders at the end of the first period, 3-2 Montreal at the end of the second. Bob Bourne tied it up at the 8:42 mark. Galeen gave the Islanders a lead at 10:08. And Napier's goal is tied it again at 4-4 with a minute to play. And that's Goring shooting it around the boards in the Montreal zone. Over comes Nystrom. Bob Nystrom and Green bumped together. Walter has cleared it up left wing and down into the Islanders zone. Icing has been popped. So Potvin deals it off to Thomas Janssen. Janssen takes a look. The pass goes to Goring. Butch Goring carries it across the Montreal line, trying to come in around Green. A centering attempt block. Potvin moved in, couldn't get a shot. Here's Janssen. Thomas Janssen goes in deep. Back of the net. Checked by Robinson. Nystrom will pick it up. Bob Nystrom centering attempt. Went off Janssen, and Robinson winds up. Larry Robinson got it to the blue line for Wickenheiser. 18 seconds left as he comes to the other line. Drop pass. Napier's play was broken up, and offside is called. Randy Mitten. blue line, called it offside with 15 seconds left in the hockey game.
Doug Wickenheiser, as he came across right there, the puck did not clear the blue line in time, and they were offside. Mark Napier taking the drop pass from Wickenheiser, but it was offside.
So now with 15 seconds left, Al Arbor has Brian Trottier, John Tinelli, and Mike Bossy on the ice with Langevin and Pearson. Acton will take the draw for Canadiens. Comes back in over the line to Langevin, off to Pearson. Stefan Pearson to John Tinelli up the right wing to Bossy, who shot it in wide of Wamsley. Wamsley plays it to the corner, over goes Nyland. Langevin comes in, 2 seconds left, and we'll end at a 4-4 tie as the siren sounds. In the final period, the Islanders had 8 shots on goal, and the Canadiens had 10. The Canadiens come back with that goal from Napier at 17:35.
Introducing the new Chevrolet Impala. It's a whole new animal.
It was a matchup that had to happen. Matt Merrill, leading scorer of the Sugar Mill League, versus Frosty McFreeze, a player simply made to play in goal. On paper, the match looked even. On paper. The Home Depot is proud to help build community and backyard rinks all across Canada, where the real great moments in hockey happen. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Player Profile is brought to you by Gatorade. It's in Team Canada. Is it in you?
And our Gatorade player profile is TJ Oshie of the Edmonton, who's with our Ryan Rashog.
Well, TJ, a pretty tight game out there. How do you think your team's been playing?
Well, we've been playing pretty well. We got to play in their offensive zone. That's all there is to it. Stop taking penalties.
Their goaltender is a guy that can steal a game. What do you got to do to start putting some pucks past him?
We just got to crash the net. You know, they're doing a really good job holding us up. And, we just got to get to the net, bang home some rebounds.
TJ, thanks.
Thank you.
For the record, Bozzi has come clean and remembered he did call the Americans heavy favorites 1 month ago. For you keeping score at home, Duffy won, McKenzie nothing. Canada versus Finland. The